Hello everybody, welcome to Pinnacle Online Coaching Classes. In this video lecture, I'm going to talk about closed test with you. Closed test, a very important topic for SSC CGL Tier 2. And on this topic, Pinnacle has made a complete series of 20 video lectures. 20 video lectures are going to be made, and this is part 1. This is part 1 of the lecture. When I talk to a lot of students, I often ask them as to which section is there in the paper where they lose the maximum marks. And the simple answer that I get is, ma'am, it's closed test. And when I ask them, why is it closed test? They simply say that this is one section where we simply go by intuition. Out of the four options that are available, whichever we feel my heart says this is correct, I go with that. No logic is applied at all. In fact, I even meet some very smart students who say, I first see the options and then I read the closed test, and whichever fits in, I just fit that. In fact, more than half, around 70% students, 60 to 70% students do not have any strategy for closed test. First, closed test is one section where they do not have any strategy, and then para jumbles. We have already made a series on para jumbles, and now many of the students who are a part of our Pinnacle Online Coaching Batch or who are a part of our Job Assure Tier 2 program, they have mailed me saying that para jumbles is now under their control, and that is one section which was the least scoring earlier, but now it has become under control and they do very well in that section. Similarly, I want you to become I want you to score a good score in closed test and stop going by simple intuitions. Here, where you are going to answer a paper where there is negative marking, how can you just go by intuition? And since closed test is a very important section for Tier 2 exam, the English Tier 2 exam for SSC CGL Tier 2, that is the reason, realizing the importance of this section, Pinnacle is making this complete series of 20 video lectures. And in this series, I'm going to go step by step from the very basic to what is a closed test, to what is the difference between closed tests in banks and closed tests asked in SSC CGL, different kind of paragraphs which are given, what should be the strategy, what is the importance of the tone of the passage, how do you identify the tone of the passage, what is needed to score well, how is grammar related knowledge to be applied for closed test, how are connectors, prepositions, adverbs, relative pronouns, nouns, all of them to be used. What if you feel that the sentence is complete even without the blank, then in such a situation, what is to be filled up? And finally, even when you feel that none of the option is fitting in according to you and you have exhausted all your knowledge, then what is to be done? Everything is going to be covered under these 20 video lectures. Everything is going to be covered. I will cover everything under the sun related to closed test, and plenty of questions which have appeared in the previous years, they are also going to be discussed. Now, this series of 20 video lectures, it's a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program. It's a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program, and Job Assure Part 2 program, it's a daily, day-wise planned program to clear SSC CGL Tier 2 exam. It is a day-wise designed program to clear SSC CGL Tier 2, accompanied by a daily test also, so that you can see how you are performing, how you are studying, and how you are progressing. Now, having said all that, let's begin part one of closed test. Very important. Let's start. First and foremost, we need to understand what exactly is a closed test. What exactly is a closed test, and why is it that students lose maximum marks in this section? First and foremost, a closed test consists of a passage. You will be given a passage, and then certain words are going to be removed from that passage. In the year around 1956, closed test became was introduced and became a part of various examinations that were conducted all over the world. And then it was introduced in around the year 1956. And then what is done? We simply take a passage and then certain words are removed from the passage. And in place of these words that are removed, blanks are inserted. In place of the removed words, blanks are given. And then at the end of the passage, the blanks are number. At the end of the passage, these blanks which are a part of the passage, they are going to be numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, as many blanks are there. Generally, blanks can range between 5 to 20. 5 to 20 they can range between, but for SSC exam you will get one closed test which is small in size, it will have 5 blanks, and you will get two average ones which will have around 10 blanks. So total 25 questions are going to be asked from closed test. So the blanks are going to be numbered 1 to as many blanks are there, and then at the end of the passage the numbers will be given along given again, and for each number there are going to be 4 or 5 options. In banking exams, there are 5 options. In SSC, there are 4 options. Like for example, you have a blank in the passage. Suppose this is a sentence and yes, there's a blank. In the next sentence, there's a blank. Suppose this is blank 1 and this is blank 2. At the end of the passage, 1 and 2 will be written. Against 1, there'll be 4 options. Against 2, there'll be 4 options. 4 or 5, depending upon the exam. Then, a candidate must replace the missing words from the given options to make it contextually meaningful. Out of the 4 options that are given to you, you have to choose the right option and you have to fill in the blank which is there in the passage. Now, a lot of students ask me, ma'am, isn't this fill in the blanks? In fact, even when I ask students which section did you not do well, they'll say, ma'am, that fill in the blanks which I got in a passage. That sometimes even that is the answer. Now, what is the difference between a closed test and a fill in the blank? In fill in the blank, you will be just given one sentence and at the most it can have 2 blanks or 3 blanks and not more than that. But there will be only one sentence. But in a closed test, it's going to be a complete passage and you have to read the whole passage, see what is the tone of the passage, and you have to fill in contextually. When you fill it up, then it should be correct. You have to fill in the context of the passage, and when you read the whole passage after filling in the blanks, it should make sense. That is the difference. In fill in the blanks, you will be just given one blank and a word has to be filled in there. You do not have to fill it up with reference to the whole passage, but here the whole passage has to be read. The whole passage has to be read. The tone of the passage has to be identified. You have to have a little knowledge about grammar also. You have to have a little knowledge about vocabulary also. And sometimes I even feel that if a little background knowledge of the subject is there, then also it's important. That also helps you. Because sometimes I see there are you might be given a closed test about the solar system, or you might be given a closed test about Mahatma Gandhi's stay in England or his stay in Africa. In such situations, if you have a little knowledge about that topic, it is definitely going to help you. Now, if I am given a topic about some topic, if I am given a closed test about organic chemistry, maybe I'm going to be blank about it. But if I am given a topic on any of the social studies subjects like civics or history or geography, because I have read on these topics, I'm going to be comfortable. So if you ask me what is needed to crack this topic, then I will definitely say a little bit of many things. A little bit of grammar, a little bit of vocabulary, a little bit of reading habit, a little bit of information if it is a scientific topic, a technological topic, a historical topic, a geographical topic, a little bit of knowledge about these things, and then finally even logic and reasoning and your presence of mind. All these things are needed to crack this topic. But however, there are certain situations where you might feel that none of the options given is fitting in the blank. Now, what is to be done in those situations? I will discuss that also with you. So here in this slide, we discussed what is closed test. And now let us move on to the next point about it. Now, what is the importance of closed test? How important is this topic for you to crack the exam? As I already told you, this is one of those sections where students do not score well. And if 25 questions are given and if they feel that around 18 or 19 are correct, some of them feel this is a good score, but this is not actually a good score. For all those students who are watching this video and feel that they're already scoring 160 or 162, 164, 165 and they wish to improve, let me tell them that this is one area where they can improve. Most of the students do not do well here, and if you want to get an edge, try to master closed test, and it is possible to master them. When we analyzed previous year's papers of different exams, we realized that this is a very, very important section. Not only for SSC CGL, it can be asked in Tier 1 also. It is asked in Tier 2 definitely. It can be asked in LDC. Exams related to insurance, IBPS PO, clerk, SBP IPO, state government exams, CLAT, railway, MAT, SAT, all other examinations. This is a very, very important section. Very, very important section. It is common in all the exams and one of the important sections of English. In most of the exams, you can expect 5 to 10 questions from this topic. But for SSC, CGL, Tier 2 exam, 25 questions are going to be asked from this topic. You will be given 3 close tests. This is what has been the trend. You will be given 3 close tests. The first one will have 10 blanks. The second one will also have 10 blanks. And the third close test which you will be given, the third passage which you will be given, that will have 5 blanks. So total in all, 25 questions are going to be given from this topic. Very, very important section. Very, very important section. Only comprehension will be, more questions will be asked from comprehension and a narration as in comparison to this topic. Close test is a very, very important topic to clear SSC CGL Tier 2. And if you are going by fluke, if you are going by intuition that, okay, this is the right answer, let me just mark it. Stop doing that. You need to score very well in this section. Very, very important. Very, very important. Next one. Now, let us see. Now, let me even compare SSC and banking close tests for you. Because a lot of students ask me, they say that, ma'am, okay, fine, I'll develop reading habit, but what should I exactly read? See, what are you exactly preparing for? What are you preparing for? This is the question that you need to ask. Every exam will have comprehension. But are comprehensions of banks and comprehensions of SSC similar? Every bank will have spot the error in the sentence, but are the questions given similar in type? If you examine them very minutely and you are able to analyze, you will realize that SSC asks completely different types of close tests and banking close tests are very, very different. Very, very different. And the difference between the both of them, first is that SSC will give you 4 options. SSC will give 4 options and banks will give us 5 options. And more the number of options for you, it becomes all the more difficult for you to answer. Because some of the students even tell me that when I have more options, I am more confused rather than helping me. Options confuse me. And banks generally asked financial topics related to banks. The passages which are given to you, they will be related to banks and economy. They can be related to, in fact, definitely in most of the exams that I have seen, if it is a paper related to banking, especially PO, financial topics play a crucial role there. Economy plays a very, very important role there. And if you are a student from the arts background or you are from a BTech, then maybe you do not have knowledge about terms like inflation, devaluation, repo rate, exchange rate and all these kind of things. You may not have knowledge about them, but definitely a little knowledge about economics, a little knowledge about the banking sector helps you to solve the close tests given for banking exams. So if you are preparing for banking exams, there are different types of close tests. And if you are preparing for SSC, then it is going to be different types of close tests which are going to be given to you. Generally, SSC will not give you close tests related to economy, banking, etc. Close tests given for SSC are very different. What type are they? We will see that also so that you exactly know what to read. Don't go for a general preparation. A general preparation will not take you anywhere. Every exam requires a special kind of preparation. If you keep reading topics like topics related to banking and economy and you are going to appear for SSC, then it will become totally irrelevant. Now let us see what does SSC ask. Concept based supported by facts and numbers. These kind of close tests are asked in banks. You will be given a concept. They're going to be concept based and they're going to be supported by facts and numbers and difficult in level. I would say the close tests that are given for bank PO exams, SBI PO and all that, they are more difficult than what is given for SSC. In SSC, generally, financial topics related to banks and economy are not asked. They are not asked, and even if they are asked, they are going to be simpler. They are going to be simpler. You could be asked about cottage industries, but you will not be asked a very difficult topic. The level of SSC close tests is simple as in comparison to banking exams. Even the language used is going to be simple. In banking exams, even in the close test, you might find about 4 to 5 words where you do not know the meaning. And a lot of students, they get stuck up there and they keep thinking about the meaning of that particular word. Even if you do not understand the meaning of one particular word, just try to keep moving on and try to get the gist of the passage. That is important. You needn't know the meaning of each and every word used in the passage. But this will rarely happen in SSC. Generally, the language used in SSC closed tests is simple. The language used in SSC closed tests is simple, and even the topics that are chosen and given are simpler as in comparison to banking. So this is one section of the paper, English paper, where banking ones are difficult and the ones given in SSC are simpler. Now let us take a look at what are the topics that you should focus upon if you are preparing for a closed test for SSC. What are the topics that SSC chooses? Now, kinds of closed tests asked in SSC. What are the closed tests that SSC can ask? They can give you a simple story-based closed test. In this, an incident could be given to you. Okay, an incident could be given to you, and that entire incident is going to be narrated, and you will be given blanks to fill it up in the closed test. You could be given about social issues. Social issues could be related to child marriage. It could be child labor. It could be related to female feticide, etc. So social topics could be given. Environmental topics could be given related to pollution in the sea, related to the ozone layer, related to the melting of the ice caps, etc. So issues related to the environment could be given. Incident narrated. Story could be a simple story. You could have heard a story during your childhood, a small story that could be given as a closed test. In the latter part of this series, definitely I am going to do each and every kind of these with you so that you know how to solve them. It could even be an incident narrated where any particular incident about somebody's life has been narrated and you have to fill it up. Then you could have closed tests related to history. You could have closed tests related to World War I, World War II, the Indian National Movement. You could have a closed test related to personalities of history, like for example, Martin Luther King, or about Gandhiji, etc. So here I would say in historical, ecological, geographical and political. Here if you have a little knowledge about these things, definitely it is going to be helpful. Now, if you are given a closed test about Abraham Lincoln, suppose you have been given a closed test about the problems of blacks, and you are also discussing about Abraham Lincoln. If you are blank about Abraham Lincoln, definitely a student who has some knowledge about him, he will have an edge over you. So historical closed tests are also given, ecological closed tests are also given, and then there are closed tests related to geography, and finally political. There could be a passage which has been picked up from a civics book. It could be about the Panchayati Raj institutions, it could be about the local self-government, it could be about elections, it could be about the election commission, it could be about booth capturing, etc. during elections. So if you have a little knowledge about these things, definitely it is going to prove to be highly beneficial for you. Now, what was my purpose of this presentation in part one of the series? My purpose was that now you exactly get an idea as to what are the topics that you should read if you are planning to prepare for closed test. If you are planning to prepare for closed test, I just wanted to give you a rough idea about that so that you exactly know if you are preparing for banking, then what are you supposed to read? If you are preparing for SSC, then what are you supposed to study? Do the right kind of study, which is extremely important. In the next part, that is in part two, I am going to discuss with you what should be your strategy. What should be your strategy and what do you exactly need to crack closed test? And after that, in part three, a lot of students tell me that, ma'am, I know my rules of grammar. I know them. I have read all of them. I have practiced enough of them. But I do not know how to apply that to closed test. So in one part of the series, I'm even going to discuss that with you so that you know exactly how your knowledge is to be applied. This was the last part for part one of closed test. And I wish you all the very, very best. Let me just remind you that this series on closed test, which will contain 20 video lectures, it's a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program. It's a part of our Job Assure Part 2 program, and I am going to make 20 videos in all so that you know exactly how you have to tackle close tests. Similarly, we have made a complete series on active passive also, on narration also, para jumbles, so that all these topics which are very, very important for SSC CGL Tier 2, you have a good hold over them. I wish you all the very, very best, and very soon I am going to be before you in which we are going to do part 2 of close test. All the best. Thank you.